myself and Bhoomika from my team members, Jyoti, Sarika and Nivetha. So first we'll talk about the historical timeline of Andaman and Nicobar Islands.
You can see 1962, Andaman was rich in endemic species. For example, Andaman duck, then many pigeons, etc. And in the year 1972, it can be seen high rich population of dugongs. And in that period of time, till 1982, elephants were seen regularly and were protected also. But as the time goes,
seasonal chart. So in summer you can see the minimum temperature in Andaman and Nicobar Islands is 24 degrees Celsius and maximum is 37 degrees Celsius. And in rainy season the maximum temperature is 33 degrees Celsius and minimum is 25 degrees Celsius. And this rainy season was also present in May to September. Autumn season have the maximum temperature of 33 degrees Celsius and minimum temperature of 25 degrees Celsius. Autumn season is mainly present in September, October and November. The spring season has the maximum temperature of 33 degrees Celsius and temperature 25 degrees Celsius. This season is present in March, April.
Passing four seasons, mainly in Andaman is summer, winter, autumn and spring.
In summer season, the wildlife found is more dragonflies, crickets and grasshoppers. Wildlife edible is dandelions. Fruiting fruit in summer season is mango, lychees, kiwi and grapes. Towering tank is very good. Thank you. questions? Anybody?
Myself, Komal Kamal. I think that according to me, a vision defines the optimal desires of future state. It tells us what we would like to achieve over the long time.
Thank you, Komal. And my second question is, why is it important to set a vision for the future career?
Career vision statement opens your eyes to what is possible and gives you something tangible to move forward.
Thank you.
Thank you, Babuji. A very good response. So here you can see we have made a vision. First is the educational sector. So anybody can say what is the literacy rate of India? Yes?
Myself and Samiksha, the literacy rate of India is 77%.
Thank you, Samiksha. As she said, the literacy rate of India is 77%, but we want in future 100% literacy rate, that so that the India can be a developed country. And the second is, there should be right for education to all the children. There should be no discrimination. And for example, there are two types of child. First child is getting a new job and he is earning many money, but he is investing all his money for his own self. And the second child is, he is earning money, but he is investing all his money for the improvement of society. So what we should be? First child or second child?
Second.
Yes, we should be like a second child. This was all about the educational sector. Second is the agricultural sector. We have to invest our money. If we get a good job, we have to invest our money in the agriculture so that we can help out to our farmers and we can build our nation as a developed country. And the third is about the clean and building. Our third sector is about the society, social society, that we can say that we should build our city as a clean and green city. We should use smart appliances. In future, we have to use smart appliances, but we have to keep our society as clean and green. This was all about the third sector, but now fourth sector is, we have to treat all religion as one religion. Our India has launched a mission, Mangal mission, to the Mars. We have reached till Mars. We have found the water molecules in Moon also. But what about the people of Earth? What about the people of India? They are still fighting. They are just wanting for justice. So we want all religions should be treated as one religion, and we should be like fruits of one tree, waves of one sea, and the branch of leaves of one branch. We want unity, peace, equality, fraternity, liberation, all the fundamental rights of which we are reading in social. So this was our vision for future. So do you have any questions?
What we are going to achieve and how we can achieve it?
So a very good question. Here we can say that we have to achieve our goals. Means these are our goals, these are our mission, vision. So who will play a very important role in this? Youth will play a very important role in this. Because youth have a potential and it has many energy that can change the whole world. So youth are the very important role that we can change the whole world.